My name is Dinara Azimova, and I'm a junior specialist in the Nystul lab at UCSF. Junior specialist is a title role, but I'm a lab tech slash lab manager, so I take care of the lab inventory and safety as well as do research in the lab. In the Nystul lab, we're working on stem cells, particularly adult epithelial stem cells. And this can most closely be related to cancer because there is a theory that stem cells can be the cause of cancer or the first cells that could become cancerous in a field of tissue. So what we're looking at is we're seeing the very first steps of a stem cell becoming more cancer-like. In a way, we're looking at competitive stem cells. So if stem cells started becoming better at staying in the tissue than other stem cells, they can outcompete them, and hence they can cause the very first steps down a pathway of a cancerous fate for the tissue. So I was born in Tashkent, Uzbekistan, actually. My parents were both scientists there, and we immigrated to America in 1999, so I was only in the half, but my parents immigrated to America for the sake of science. So they were trying to become scientists here in the US in LA, UCLA. And so I kind of had science growing up as a kid. I was always in lab with my parents. They would make me do like really small things, like, oh, like, can you like fill the pipette boxes, or can you do this with us? So it was a great experience for me as a kid. And then they also helped me, encourage me to volunteer in labs as well when I was a high schooler. And so I knew when I got to college that I would want to pursue the scientific path. And so I continued in college with a degree in molecular biology. And here I'm taking some time to learn more techniques before I apply to graduate school. A typical day for me, I usually come in around 9:30 or 10, and I take care of any lab business that pops up. So I'm in charge of ordering supplies for the lab, making sure that we have all the fly food available, and making sure that the flies are happy as well. And then I also go into my own experience as well. So when we work with flies, we usually we look at their ovaries usually, so we have to stain those ovaries with different antibodies, so to see if we can see any markers for maybe stem cells, if we can find any for that, or if the cell looks different. That's what we're trying to find in our genetic mutants for flies. And so what we do is we dissect those flies, and then we have to stain them, and that protocol usually takes about a day. So you just have to go through all these different wash steps and making sure that the antibodies take to the ovaries as well. So that takes about a day, and then you look at your slides, the ones that you produce from those stainings, and you look at them on a microscope. We usually do immunofluorescence microscopy, and we do a lot of cell counting, and we do a lot of just observing whether the tissue looks normal or not, or what looks weird about it. Honestly, I think the most exciting part is to hang out with the people in the lab. I think the lab environment is very important, and I really enjoy working with these people.
And you're right, they don't quite line up perfectly, but they're two slightly different enzymes. I have no idea why. Maybe it's just the different blood ends that they're stuck with.
Probably.
Wild guesses. No clue.
It's always inspirational to look at them working and helping me work as well. With science, there's a pretty steep learning curve when you enter the lab. You have to learn a lot, you have to learn quickly. And I think the hardest part is not being intimidated by that. I think as soon as you become intimidated, everything just turns out really bad. Because you start worrying about it, and then you don't realize that it affects your work ethic. And so I think the biggest obstacle is not being intimidated to push yourself forward into new fields and to go to new places and actually be proactive about your research. I think the way I overcame that is to literally tell myself, don't be scared. Like, that's the one thing you can't be if you want to proceed further in this field. If you want to hit disease at the source, you'd have to go through science. And if you want to understand disease, you have to study it at the molecular level. And whether it be bacteria or viruses or even other, you know, parasites that very little is known about, I think you have to start with basic science, and you have to understand how regular biology works within a cell, or how under a normal condition how things function. And so I think in that case, biology and science in general is what can create these solutions to worldwide disease problems and other pandemics like the Ebola pandemic that we have right now. I think basic science research is going to help the world in the future.